In this video, we'll take a look at Terraform versus Ansible. This topic has been confusing to many because the two have similarities and can overlap in some cases. This is part one of a two-part series. In this video, we will learn the differences between Ansible and Terraform. And in the second video, I will demo both for you to solidify what you've just learned in this video. I also have a blog post that I will link to in the description below. Finally, I have a Terraform 101 course if you're interested in learning more about Terraform. Hi, I'm Sam Gabriel, and let's get started. In this video, we will cover the following. What is Terraform? What is Ansible? Infrastructure as code, configuration management, mutable and immutable infrastructure, idempotence, declarative and imperative programming. So let's get started. Terraform is an open source infrastructure as code software tool that allows you to define and manage infrastructure resources in a safe and predictable way. It's developed by HashiCorp. Terraform is particularly popular for creating and managing infrastructure resources across multiple cloud infrastructure providers, including AWS, Azure, and Google Cloud. It can also be used for existing infrastructure running on-premises on vSphere or Nutanix. With Terraform, you can use simple declarative configuration files to describe the infrastructure resources you need, and then use the Terraform command line, CLI, to create and manage those resources. Terraform can create and manage resources such as virtual machines, network interfaces, DNS records, and much more. One of the key benefits of using Terraform is that it allows you to version your infrastructure and track changes over time. This makes it easier to collaborate with others and track the history of your infrastructure. Terraform also has a large and active community, which means that there are many resources and plugins available for extending its capabilities. Terraform's sweet spot is provisioning resources. Ansible is an open source configuration management and infrastructure management tool. That makes it easy to deploy and manage applications in large-scale environments. It automates configuration processes and reduces deployment time, ensuring configuration consistency across all different types of systems, such as virtual machines, network devices, and containers. Ansible uses an agentless architecture, which means that it does not require any software to be installed on the managed servers. Instead, it uses SSH to connect to the servers and perform tasks. It works by connecting over SSH or Windows Remote Management, WinRM, and pushing out configuration changes such as tasks, playbooks, or modules. This makes it much quicker to configure multiple hosts across distributed networks while providing the flexibility to do so without requiring specialized configuration languages. One of the key benefits of using Ansible is that it allows you to automate repetitive tasks and ensure that your infrastructure is consistently configured. It also has a large and active community, which means that there are many resources and plugins available for extending its capabilities. Ansible's sweet spot is configuration management. While it can provision resources, it lacks the ability to store the infrastructure state. More on this later. Let's take a step back and define infrastructure as code, or IAC for short. IAC is an approach to managing infrastructure in which infrastructure resources are defined and managed using code and configuration files rather than using manual processes. This allows you to version, automate, and reuse your infrastructure in the same way that you would with software code. Using infrastructure as code has several benefits. It allows you to define your infrastructure in a declarative way, which makes it easier to understand and maintain. It also makes it easier to automate the provisioning and management of your infrastructure, as you can use tools to apply your configuration files and make changes to your resources. Additionally, IAC makes it easier to collaborate with others and track the history of your infrastructure, as you can use version control systems to track changes to your configuration files. There are a number of tools available for managing infrastructure as code, including Terraform, CloudFormation, and Azure Resource Manager. These tools allow you to define your infrastructure using configuration files and then use the tool's command line interfaces to apply those configurations and manage your resources. Some have added Ansible, Chef Puppet, and the like to the list, which have made things confusing. Ansible, Chef, and Puppet are more suited as configuration management tools. So let's now take a closer look at configuration management. Now, configuration management is the process of maintaining and controlling the configurations of infrastructure resources in an organized and predictable way. This includes tasks such as installing and updating software, managing system packages, and configuring servers and other infrastructure resources. Some examples of configuration management tools include Ansible, Chef, Puppet, and SaltStack. These tools allow you to define the desired state of your infrastructure using configuration files or scripts, and then use the tool's command line interfaces to apply those configurations and manage your resources. Configuration management tools can be used in conjunction with infrastructure as code tools such as Terraform to provide a complete solution for managing and configuring your infrastructure. In infrastructure as code, the infrastructure state refers to the current configuration and status of your infrastructure resources. This includes details such as the number and type of resources that are currently deployed, the configuration of those resources, and their current status. Tools that support IAC typically provide a way to store the infrastructure state, which allows you to track the current state of your infrastructure and use it as a reference for making changes. This is often done using a state file, which is a file that contains the current state of your infrastructure resources. Storing the infrastructure state is important for several reasons. It allows you to track the current state of your infrastructure and understand what resources are currently deployed. It also makes it easier to plan and apply changes to your infrastructure, as you can use the stored state as a reference for understanding the current state of your resources. Storing the infrastructure state allows you to version and track changes to your infrastructure over time, which can be useful for collaboration and debugging. When it comes to Ansible versus Terraform, Terraform stores the state of the infrastructure, whereas Ansible does not. This gives Terraform an advantage over Ansible because it would take more lines of code to get Ansible to work around the lack of state storage. But does it really matter? This leads us to the topic of mutable versus immutable infrastructure. Now, mutable infrastructure is an approach to managing infrastructure in which resources are modified in place rather than replaced. This means that when you want to make a change to an infrastructure resource, you modify the existing resource rather than create a new version of it. Ansible can be used to help manage mutable infrastructure by providing a way to automate the configuration and management of infrastructure resources. With Ansible, you can write simple playbook scripts to describe the desired state of your infrastructure, and then use the Ansible command line interface to apply the playbooks to your resources. This makes it easier to manage the configuration of your infrastructure over time, as you can use Ansible to ensure that your resources are consistently configured and up to date. One of the key benefits of using mutable infrastructure is that it can be easier to manage in some cases, as you can make changes to resources directly rather than needing to recreate them. However, it can also be more difficult to track changes and roll back if necessary, as it is harder to see exactly what changes have been made to a resource. It is also generally considered to be less robust and secure than immutable infrastructure, as there is a greater risk of unintended changes being made to your infrastructure. The immutable infrastructure approach is a way to manage infrastructure in which resources are replaced rather than modified in place. This means that when you want to make a change to an infrastructure resource, you create a new version of that resource rather than modifying the existing one. Terraform can be used to help manage immutable infrastructure by providing a way to define and create infrastructure resources in a predictable and versionable way. With Terraform, you can use configuration files to describe the desired state of your infrastructure and then use the Terraform CLI to create and manage those resources. This makes it easier to recreate your infrastructure from scratch if necessary, as you can use your configuration files as a reference for building out your resources. One of the key benefits of using immutable infrastructure is that it makes it easier to track changes and roll back if necessary. Since you're replacing resources rather than modifying them in place, it is easier to see what exactly changed and revert to a previous state if necessary. It's also generally considered to be more robust and secure as it reduces the risk of unintended changes being made to your infrastructure. In computer science, idempotent refers to an operation that has no additional effect if it is called multiple times with the same input. In other words, an idempotent operation will produce the same result no matter how many times it is called, as long as the input is the same. In the context of a configuration management tool like Ansible or a provisioning tool such as Terraform, idempotence is an important concept because it allows these tools to ensure that the desired state of a system is consistently maintained. For example, in Terraform, if you use a resource configuration to create an AWS EC2 instance, and you run the same configuration multiple times, Terraform will ensure that only one EC2 instance is created. If the EC2 instance already exists, Terraform will not try to create it again because the resource configuration is idempotent. This ensures that the desired state of the infrastructure is consistently maintained and helps to prevent unintended changes or errors. Similarly, if you use Ansible to install a package on a server and you run the same playbook multiple times, Ansible will ensure that the package is installed once only. If the package is already installed, Ansible will not try to install it again because the installation is idempotent. This ensures that the server is not unnecessarily modified and helps to prevent unintended changes or errors. Overall, idempotence is an important concept in configuration management tools because it allows these tools to consistently maintain the desired state of a system and helps to prevent unintended changes or errors. Imperative programming is a programming paradigm that focuses on specifying how a program should be executed by explicitly defining the steps or instructions that the program should follow. And in imperative programming, the programmer specifies the exact sequence of steps that the program should take to solve a problem. And the program executes these steps in order. Imperative programming languages typically provide control structures such as loops and conditional statements that allow the programmer to specify the exact flow of execution. Examples of imperative programming language include C, C++, and Java. Ansible falls under this category. Declarative programming is a programming paradigm that focuses on specifying what a program should do rather than how it should be done. In declarative programming, the programmer specifies the desired outcome or result of the program, and the program determines the best way to achieve that result. Declarative programming languages typically do not provide explicit control structures for the specifying the flow of execution, and instead rely on the programmer to specify the desired result and let the language or runtime determine the best way to achieve it. Examples of declarative programming languages include SQL, HTML, and Terraform. In general, you would use Terraform to create and manage your infrastructure resources, and then use Ansible to configure and manage those resources once they're up and running. However, it is also possible to use both tools together, as Terraform can be used to set up the infrastructure and pass information about the created resources over to Ansible for further configuration. I hope this has been useful, and you can learn more in the next video where I demo both Ansible and Terraform provisioning an AWS EC2 instances. You'll also see how they differ and what to look out for. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And as promised, look out for the next video where I demo both Ansible and Terraform in AWS launching an EC2 instance to compare the differences between the two, what to look out for, what I mean by state files and keeping the state of the infrastructure, and so on. So stay tuned, and I will see you in the next video.